Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here in Computex 2025 from the G.Skill booth. And today with us, we have a good old friend of ours, Mark. Hey, Mark, how's it going?
Hi.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you again.
All right, man. So every year you guys have this amazing overclocking contest, actually World Cup final overclocking contest.
Right.
Can you tell us a little bit more of the background, how it works? How does it develop throughout the year? And if someone wanted to take part in that, how they will do, how they engage in that?
Okay. So every year we have a extreme overclocking competition called the OC World Cup. And this is an invitational pretty much for all the overclockers from around the world to join in. And the first stage of that starts usually in February, and we have an online competition, an online qualifier stage. And it lasts through about 6 weeks or so. And there's a couple of benchmarks you have to run through. It's different every single year. And once you finish those and complete those benchmarks, we select the top 9 overclockers and invite them over to Computex, to the G.Skill booth, for the live qualifier cycle or a stage. And the live qualifier, they would compete over 3 days over a pre-selected set of benchmarks. And then on the last day, the top 3 from there, from the live qualifier stage, would go into the finals to determine the final first, second, and third places of the OC competition. And then the OC champion, first place, would get $10,000 USD in cash prize.
And that's what is going on right now, like in the stage over there. Right. That's the finals to figure it out today on Friday.
Yes.
The overall champion.
Yes. We have 3 contestants right there on this year's OC World Cup. Today is the last day of Computex. We have the grand finals, and it's going to end in less than 2 hours right now.
That is awesome. Can you give us a couple of names of what type of benchmarks they're doing right now?
So it's always different every year. But we do have some selections. We have memory frequency, highest memory frequency. We have Y-Cruncher, 7-Zip, Geekbench, Super Pi 32M. So that's something that they have to complete within a span of like 5 hours. So you can imagine the intensity and the knowledge that comes into.
Yeah, the intensity, the concentration, all the stuff they have to do to make sure that like they highest score, highest frequency, or lowest time, depending on which benchmark you're doing in order to
get exactly.
Wow, that's great. We can't wait to see who's going to be the winner on that side. Now, we're talking about overclocking. Mm-hmm. I see in this system here, I was walking by with you, and I saw 10,933 mega transfers per second.
Yes, that's correct.
Is that for the RAM memory that you have in here?
So we always show the latest and the fastest demonstration, like what is supported. For what might be supported for the latest platforms. So this year, the highest we got to show everybody is DDR5 10,933, or 34, if you round up.
Yep.
Right. And so this is on an Intel platform, and this is as high as we've ever shown. So we always focus on the highest speeds, highest capacities, or lowest latencies. And this happens to be the fastest speed.
That is awesome. That is pretty great. Also, we were talking earlier, we mentioned about like new types of densities for memory.
We're
used to seeing like 8, 16, 32, but you guys are working on something else, right?
Right. So traditionally there are the binary numbers, the 8 gigabytes, 16 gigabytes, 32 gigabytes. And then later on in DDR5, we're seeing the non-binary capacity modules. And those are actually overclocked very well. They are offered in really high speeds or low latencies. So we have 24 gigabytes or 48 gigabyte modules to get 48 gigabyte kits or 96 gigabyte kits. Now, in the coming months, we're going to go into 64 gigabyte modules. Wow. So you're going to start seeing 128 gigabyte kits with 2 modules of 64 gigabytes. That's something you can look forward to.
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to just having that on my system. It'll be pretty nice.
Yeah.
Especially with all the different workloads for if anybody's a content creator or if you're doing nowadays different types of machine learning workloads or anything like that.
Absolutely. Content creation, video rendering is super helpful. Illustrator, Photoshop, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, that makes sense. Mark, thanks so much for having us here. I can't wait to see who's going to be winning the OC World Cup Championship, and it's great to see you again.
Great to see you. Thanks for stopping by.
Thanks for having us.